हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ चमेली देवी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी इंदौर। सो टुडे आई एम हियर अगेन विद अनदर टॉपिक ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिक्स। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सेमी सॉलिड डोजेस फॉर्म, दैट इज जेली। सो लेट्स सी द इंट्रोडक्शन। ओके, सो जेलीज आर ट्रांसपेरेंट और ट्रांसलूशेंट नॉन ग्रीसी सेमी सॉलिड preparation. They meet for external application to the skin or mucous membrane. Jellies are mainly applied on mucous membrane for lubricating antiseptic purpose. Jellies are also used for lubricating surgical gloves, catheters and rectal thermometer. Most commonly jellies used vaginal jellies, contraceptive jellies. So basically jellies are thin transparent or translucent non-greasy preparations meant for external application. Now the type of jelly. So on the basis of application, jellies are classified into three types. First is medicated jelly, second is lubricating jelly, and third is miscellaneous jellies. Now the first is medicated jelly. So in medicated jelly, considerable amount of water present, so therefore those are suitable for water soluble medicament and used for anesthetic, antiseptic and spermicidal purpose. Medicated jellies are chiefly used on mucous membrane and skin for their spermicidal, local anesthetic and antiseptic purpose. But the advantages of this medicated jelly is these jellies contain sufficient water. After evaporation of water, jellies provide a local cooling effect and residue film give protection to the skin. Now the second is lubricating jellies. So lubricating jellies used for lubrication purpose, lubrication of surgical gloves, rectal thermometer, etc. These jellies should be thin, transparent and water soluble. Although these jellies should be sterile because these are used as lubricant for articles to be inserted into sterile region of the body, such as rectal thermometer is used in rectum and urinary bladder. The third type of jellies are miscellaneous jellies. So these jellies are meant for a patch testing and electrocardiography. Patch testing jellies are used as a vehicle for allergen, which are applied on the skin to check the sensitivity. On drying, the residual film is formed, which helps to keep the patches separate and avoid confusing result. Electrocardiograph jellies is applied on the electrode to reduce the electrical resistance between the patient skin and electrode. The jelly contains sodium chloride, pumic powder and glycerin. Now the gelling agent. So in the preparation of jelly, some gelling agents are used such as natural gums, tragacanth, pectin, sodium alginate, starch, gelatin and some semi-synthetic or synthetic derivatives are also used, such as methyl cellulose and sodium carboxymethyl cellulose. First gelling agent is tragacanth. So tragacanth is commonly used for the preparation of lubricating, medicated and contraceptive jellies. The concentration of tragacanth required for the preparation of jellies varies from 2 to 5%, such as for lubricating jellies the concentration of tragacanth is 2 to 3%, for dermatological vehicle about 5%, for medicated jellies about 5%. Okay, now the jellies prepared with tragacanth usually contain lumps, so which can be avoided by using dispensing agent such as alcohol, glycerin or a volatile oil These agents are used to get homogeneous preparation. Next gelling agent is sodium alginate. So sodium alginates are used in the preparation of lubrication jellies and dermatological vehicle, and the concentration are differ in both of the jellies. So in lubricant jellies, 1.5 to 2% sodium alginate used as gelling agent, and in dermatological vehicle 5 to 10% sodium alginates used. In that type of jelly, alcohol, propylene glycol or glycerine are used as dispersing agent to avoid the formation of lumps. Next is pectin. So pectin is a valuable ingredient or gelling agent for the acid product. Pectin is a very good gelling agent. Pectin is also used in the preparation of gelling, including edible jellies. Pectin is mainly used in dermatological jellies. With pectin, glycerine is used as humectant and dispersing agents. Pectin jellies is prone to microbial growth, so a suitable preservative is needed to preserve it properly during its storage. So next gelling agent is starch. Starch jellies are prepared with the combination of glycerine and gelatin. Starch jellies prepared by heating method or fusion method. Glycerine in large amount, that is 50%, may be act as preservative and humectant. Starch mucilage prepared with the water alone leads to bacterial growth, so that suitable preservative must be added. Now the next gelling agent is gelatin. So gelatin is a soluble in hot water. 2% gelatin solution in hot water form a jelly on cooling. Very stiff medicated jelly can be prepared by incorporating with 15% gelatin. Such type of jellies are melted before use and after cooling to desired temperature. It can be applied with brush on affected area. Those applied areas are covered with bandage, and dressing may be left as such for several weeks. Cellulose derivatives. So cellulose derivatives are semi-synthetic derivatives type of gelling agents. So these include methyl cellulose and carboxy methyl cellulose. These type of gelling agents are widely used for the preparation of jellies. These substances or gelling agents are produced natural and stable jellies. These substances or gelling agent are also afford good resistance against bacterial growth. Cellulose derivatives produce a strong film on the skin after drying on skin. Sodium carboxy methyl cellulose is used for the preparation of lubricating jellies as well as used for the sterile jellies. Now, after the gelling agent, what is the preparation of jellies? So method of preparation of jellies. So the pharmaceutical jellies are usually prepared by adding a thickening agent such as tragacanth, carboxymethyl cellulose, pectin, etc. to an aqueous solution of drug. The mass is triturated in a mortar pestle until a uniform product is obtained. Most of the time, the glass mortar pestle are used in the formulation of jellies. We have studied the jellies are contain large amount of water, so these are prone to bacterial or fungal growth. So jellies must contain suitable preservative.